Martin Walsh is in our classroom. Martin Walsh is the general democratic party, the democratic system. Having our democratic for not the absolute party. Our team is going to be that we do not agree with that motion. First, Martin Walsh is doing the political system. That means the Martin Walsh is not before the Martin Walsh. The political system is feudalism. Feudalism is monarchy in that. Feudalism is autocracy. That means the reason that people, the political system is not very bad. So they look equal description and source between the people. They find high difference between the majority and the minority. That means the majority is the first and the majority is beneficial. And they do equality. So, but after the maximum motion, there is one social resource, even there is a give to opportunity. The second idea is the maximum motion bring justice. Before the maximum motion, there is low income in the payment, there is no imbalance. There is no exploitation. There is exploitation. The people in power in the payment, there is no. There is exploitation. Even the people in life conditions, the people living condition is very poor. But after the mass revolution, the people did balance payment within the worker. And have been minimized the gap between the majority and the minority. That means the bourgeois, before the revolution, the bourgeois and the proletariat is high difference. The only beneficiary the majority, people. There is high difference between the minority and the majority. So, but after the revolution, it changed the life. The left way and it's a give equal distribution of and source. There are many benefits to give the people. Generally, mass revolution is one, no one should have power over another. That's everyone should have equal, should have equal. Thank you.
Do you have a question? The other question is, don't you think that equal distribution is taking chance from disabled people?
We would like to underline, we are not talking about, or even the current mass revolution, I'm not talking about the absolute equality. Instead, it is trying to sustain equality of at least democratic and human rights. Because during that period, there is violation of, severe violation of human rights. Because until people are forced to work a lot, even if they have no opportunity to go to school or to get rest, because instead they are forced to go to school. Because even the human have human rights. The human right, for instance, and we can give an example. Human have right to live, to be alive. Therefore, their right is within this way or another way, they are violating the human right. Because even the mortality is very high. Even the payment is very small or the weight is very small. How people could survive? This is another way or indirectly they are violating human right. Therefore, when I get into the point for your question, we are not talking about absolute equality. Instead, at least the equality of the sustaining, the equality of human rights, the basic rights. Because anyone cannot be treated with the violation of human rights and democracy. Even there is no human rights that way. Therefore, the Marxist revolution are struggling for these rights, for this human right. Therefore, the human right should be kept. Because by nature, as being human, everyone is guaranteed as that right. Therefore, it doesn't have to be violated by anyone, by any means. That's why he is struggling. I think that's the answer.
About
going on in our country? Who is leading us? The war, the struggle after the revolution, many, even the revolution opened the way for many political systems. Even we can list that maybe democracy, federalism came after that, after the revolution. That's our target, because the revolution bring that change in political world. The final word, the first point is, it brings justice. We can completely say that there was no justice totally during that period, because people work a lot, but they pay less. Their wage is very small, because until I worked hard, or until I spent a lot of time in my job, I have to be paid well. That is balanced, or that is proportional to what I'm working with. But there was no justice, because the owner, the bourgeoisies, they suppress the majority. What we have to know is, the majority people is poor, and the minority or the few is rich. That means the rich person is owning the company, but the majority is ruled, or they are going to be in oppression. Therefore, even the housing condition is very poor, there is low income. Due to this low income, we can say that even there is an evidence of high mortality rate. It is because until you pay less, you cannot survive, because you have a chance, or you have maybe power to get some business. Therefore, we cannot say that the world is poor, justified by pursuing complete Marxist revolution. Instead, we can say that world is poor will not be justified by pursuing a complete Marxist revolution, because Marxist revolution doesn't make people to be poor. Instead, it's trying to get rid out of poverty within different ways, by bringing justice, by bringing equality, by introducing a new sort of economic system. That's common. Even now, we are using this with some sort of modification, and the final is by struggling the political world. Therefore, we have to notice that, we have to underline that the Marxist revolution brings many advantages. You're welcome. It's not concerned about my topic, please. Or would you clarify?
Your first topic is you are talking about Marxist on each individuals for their weight.
Mm-hmm.
So, is that better to work on each individual rather than a union?
Well, when the economic system at the union, that means that the government is involved to profit the community. What does it mean in other words? What does it mean? No? What does it mean in other words? The government is running to advantage the majority, the population, the people.
You don't give my name.
No.
Now is the time, the time.